Hello fellow plastic throwers, this is Fulcrum and we're back at the bench with the Aries Amoeba CCR, and today I'm going to be showing you how you can remove the gearbox from this gun. To start off with, you want to remove the front and back body pins. There's the other one. Now with the body pins removed, the two halves of the receiver should come apart. You want to make sure you feed a bit of wire through from the front section. And because this gun has a plastic body, you can just pop the top receiver off the top of the gearbox like so. Next up, you want to push this pin out here. Helps if you push it out the right way. And there we go. Next up, you want to fold the stock and you want to remove this flathead screw here. Go, and then the stock should come off. Next up, we want to remove the magazine release. So to start off with, you want to push the button in and you want to grab hold of the arm here and you want to pull it outwards as far as it will go and you want to turn it anti-clockwise. There we are, and then you should have the button and spring fall out the other side, or alternatively the spring could get stuck inside. Oh, there we are. So put them to one side. Now we've got to remove the pistol grip, so you want to remove the motor plate with two crosshead screws here. There we go. Next up, we want to remove the motor, and you can pull off the spade connectors whilst the motor is in situ, and then grab it by the back and lift it out like so. And as you can see, there's a tiny little plus sign, which means this side of the motor, this terminal here, is positive. Next up, we want to remove these two screws here. Make sure you do not drop them into the gearbox if you're just doing a spring change, otherwise the gearbox is gonna have to come apart. Now whilst we've loosened the screw, it will not drop out, so we want to make sure we're extra careful so we don't cause it to jump into the motor hole into the gearbox. And once the screws are loose, you should then be able to lift the pistol grip off like so and pull the wiring through. Make sure you hang on to the two screws and you know where they are so they don't fall into the inside of the gun. And now the gearbox should lift out like so. In this case, we've also managed to pinch a wire, so make sure you push the wires out of the way. And there we go. Now make sure you're extra careful around the EFCS unit so you do not damage it. Now a regular viewer on this channel asked about a spring change on this gun. Now this gearbox has a quick change spring system, which even though you have to take the gearbox out of the gun, it means you can take the spring out without having to take the gearbox apart completely. And to remove it, you want to get an Allen key that fits and you want to push inwards like so and then turn it until it pops out. It's a very similar fitting to a bayonet cap style fitting. And then you can take your replacement spring, slide it into the back of the gearbox, make sure your spring guard is in place, and then you want to wrangle the spring into place. And you want to push the little arms of the spring guard through the holes like so. And then you want to turn it at a 90 degree angle and it should pop in like so, and it should sit flush with the back of the gearbox, and you're done with your spring change. And once you've done whatever you need to do with the gearbox, you can then slide it back into the lower receiver. And in this case, I've managed to knock the bolt release out, which I can just slide in like so, and it might take a bit of fiddling, but you should be able to get it in place. There we are. Now just to keep the gearbox from jumping out whilst we're sorting everything else out, we're gonna put this pin in from earlier. There we are. That way the gearbox will stay stationary whilst we're sorting everything else out. Next up, we're going to reinstall the pistol grip, so I'm going to put the screws in first and I'm going to be extra careful so I don't drop them inside the gearbox. And the two screws should be diagonally opposite of each other. Next up, we want to feed the wires into the grip and you want to have the positive wire at the front and the negative wire through the hole in the back. And that's the negative wire. Can slowly feed the wires through, make sure we don't knock the screws out and into the hole in the gearbox, otherwise that would be a really annoying thing to happen and there'll probably be quite a bit of swearing. Next up, you want to slide the motor grip on, and whilst you're sliding on, make sure you pull in the wires gently so they don't get snagged on anything. You want to make sure you haven't pinched any wires between the grip and the gearbox casing, in which case we haven't, so we can now tighten the screws up. Next up, we want to take our motor and we want to have the positive terminal, which is on this side facing the front of the gun. And you want to make sure the wires run down the front and back of the grip beside the motor. And then we can push the spade connectors onto the terminals. Make sure you get the polarity right. Like so, and just double check. Yep, that's the positive terminal and that's the positive line. Next up, you want to make sure your motor moves freely, in which case it does. So that can move up and down as you adjust the motor height. And now we can put the plate on. Right, now that's all done, we're going to move on to the mag release. Right, now we want to put the arm of the magazine release in on this side of the gun, and then we want to put the spring on this screw here, followed by the button, and then we want to tighten it up in the same way that we removed it. So you want to turn the arm of the magazine release like so, and you want to turn it clockwise, in which case we've managed to make the magazine release turn around inside the gun, so you want to make sure it pops out like so, and there we go, magazine release is in place. And now we can pop the top receiver onto the lower receiver, and like I said before, because this gun's plastic, we can just snap it in like so, and we'll try and make sure we don't pinch the wire. And now as we're sliding the two halves together, make sure the wire isn't pinched in any way, and then we can just push them together like so, and just double check, yeah, we haven't pinched anything, that's brilliant. Now we want to reinstall the body pins, and we're going to start with the front pin which holds the two receiver halves together, which is this one with the sort of semicircular head on it. And now we want to put the last pin in the back here, which helps anchor the gearbox in place. And then finally, we want to reinstall the stock, so we can just put it on the back like so, and then get the screw we removed earlier and screw that in place. And we are done. And that's how you remove the gearbox from an Amoeba CCR Airsoft AEG. If you found this video useful, then make sure you leave a like, and if you don't want to miss out on any new Airsoft content, then make sure you subscribe and enable notifications. And as always, guys, play fair, play safe. Take care.